All right, let's do something a little more interesting. Let's make a bandpass filter circuit. Start with a resistor, Control R to rotate. Grab a capacitor. Let's put down another capacitor, Control R. Finally, another resistor, escape. F3 to draw the wires, escape. F3, escape. Oh, and we need a voltage source, of course, so F2, put that down here, F3, escape. And never ever forget the ground. Excellent. Now let's add some component values. R, let's make this 10 kiloohms. This capacitor, let's make it a nanofarad. This capacitor, let's say it's 100 picofarads. And this resistor, let's say it's going to be 20 kiloohms. As before, we have to set up our voltage source. Advanced, AC amplitude, let's do 10 volts this time. Now we have to set up our simulation, edit simulation command. AC analysis, I like to do the decade sweeps. Points per decade, let's say 100 points per decade, lots of resolution. Start at 1 hertz, and let's finish at 100 megahertz, just in case there's something interesting happening at a really high frequency. Okay, and it gives you the box, put that anywhere you want. All right, ready to run the simulation. Simulate, run. Let's see what happens on the output node. Exactly as I expected. We get a bandpass filter response on the magnitude curve. So you can see that around 36 kilohertz, the signal is about 3.8 decibels. Frequencies higher than that get attenuated, and frequencies lower than that also get attenuated. And again, if we want to look at things in terms of volts, right-click, manual limits, decimals to logarithmic. Let's make the top 20 volts because our input is 10 volts. Leave the bottom as a tiny number. Okay. And you can see the peak of the curve is about 1.5 volts. Okay. Let's see what happens when we tweak some of the values. Let's make this 1 kiloohms instead and do the same simulation. Simulate run. Output node. Ooh, the bandpass filter's center frequency has shifted up to 100 kilohertz. Okay, let's add a heavy load resistance and see what happens. What would happen if we added a 4-ohm speaker? Right-click, 4 ohms. Simulate again. So it looks like we've almost completely lost the original bandpass characteristic. And that doesn't surprise me. Take a look at the load resistance versus the other resistors in the circuit. We've got 4 ohms in parallel with 20 kiloohms. That will completely change the RC time constant of this high pass section over here. We have the series resistor of 1 kiloohm over here compared to 4 ohms over there. That's obviously going to change the entire characteristics of the circuit. So you can see that it's a really good idea to simulate your filters before you go out and build them. Otherwise, you'll put different loads on them, and then you'll be wondering, wait a minute, why aren't they working the way I thought they would? Okay, I'm tired of filters, so I'm going to show you how to simulate a little amplifier circuit that you can build out of a transistor.